Back to the Daily Grind with the only free MMA channel that fucking matters, full-time MMA. And good news for MMA fans, man. I almost thought Damian Maia might retire after losing to Tyron Woodley, just for the simple fact he's 39 years old, I believe. And, you know, he was on a 7-fight winning streak. So, I mean, who knows? His jiu-jitsu is always going to be elite. He'll always be a threat with that jiu-jitsu. And as long as he doesn't fight a fighter with the same takedown defense and strength as Tyron Woodley, he can still be very successful in this division, at least for a couple more years. So I'm glad to see Damian Maia is not retiring after the fight, and listen to what he had to say, man. It's actually motivating. It's actually not motivating like on some corny shit, but as in watching Damian Maia next fight, I'm looking forward to it just from what he had to say. So this is what Damian Maia had to say. Unfortunately for the guys in my division, I will keep going. And that's some good shit just right there. Unfortunately for the guys in my division. And that's, that just makes me think. He could be talking to Masvidal, Donald Cerrone, because, you know, he beat Masvidal once. Masvidal still wants to move up the rankings, but he's saying, hey, buddy, you might have to fight me one more time. He could be talking to a lot of people. Robbie Lawler, Donald Cerrone. I mean, Robbie Lawler said he wanted to take some, I'm telling you, it sounded like Robbie Lawler did not want any smoke with Tyron Woodley. They were asking him after his win in the octagon, hey, what do you think about a rematch with the champ? Yeah, I'm not worried about that. I'm going to go hang out with my family and my friends. And by the way, shout out to Matt Hughes. You know, he's been going through a fight. I'm going to go hang out with him. Okay, so what do you think about Tyron? Yeah, I'm not thinking about a rematch right now. Thank you. And then they walked out the octagon. They asked him at the post-fight, hey, so have you had time to think about a rematch with Tyron Woodley? Yeah, no, I'm not thinking about that yet. I'm not really not thinking about that. So, to me, from my personal opinion, it sounds like Robbie Lawler doesn't want any smoke with Tyron Woodley. Now, we'll do that on a separate video, a debate. What's next for Tyron Woodley? Because GSP doesn't want to fight him. He's beat Wonder Boy twice. He just beat Damian Maia. He could fight Masvidal, but Masvidal lost to Maia, so Masvidal might probably needs to pick up a win, and it's supposed to be Masvidal versus Wonderboy coming up soon. So, Donald Cerrone just lost. The only person I'm thinking at welterweight that could fight Tyron next is probably Robbie Lawler, and it sounds like Robbie Lawler don't want no smoke. So, Tyron Woodley might just be on the Fox desk until we can find him a new opponent, since GSP doesn't want no smoke either. I mean, and for whatever reason, I mean, whether it's because he's a boring fighter, whether it's because they don't want a concussion, whether it's because they want big numbers, whether it's because the fighter stock market's not high enough, people don't want to fight Tyron Woodley, the welterweight champion right now. And, hey, as a champion, yes, hey, that's respect. So, you know, normally guys are willing to take that risk. Like when Michael Bisping fought Luke Rockhold, hey, I'll fight him, fuck it, this is my chance at the shot. But there ain't a lot of people clamoring to fight Tyron Woodley, the welterweight champion right now, so until he gets a fight, that's on a whole nother video. I probably don't even have to do a video because I just said all of that right there. So, but Damian Maia, though. This is about Damian Maia. Let's get back to what he said. I never give up. I came into this fight on 5 weeks' notice, and I leave this fight with my head up. Now, that is true, but I don't really want to hear that as an excuse of five weeks' notice for the simple fact that you were fighting the champion. When you're fighting the champion, sometimes Michael Bisping had, 7 days' notice to fight Luke Rockhold? Came out big. So when it comes to fighting the champion, you got to take that opportunity when you can get it. Because let's say you didn't get this out. Someone else said, yes, okay, let's off the top of my head, Donald Cerrone. Let's say Jorge Masvidal, because he's not in the fight right now. Let's say Jorge Masvidal was like, hey, I know he used to be my teammate, but I'll fight. If Damian Maia don't want the fight, I'll take the fucking title shot in 5 weeks. And he came out and upset the world. Boom, Damian Maia lost his shot to right there. So when you get that opportunity for the UFC title, you got to take it, like Michael Bisping left hook Larry did versus Luke Rockhold. And now he's about to be fighting Madison Square Garden, probably headlining versus GSP. So you do have to take that shot. So I don't want to hear about the 5 week notice, but at the same time, I'm still happy with Maia's fucking tenacity and his will to keep going after losing to the champion. I mean, you know, as a 39-year-old fighter losing to the champion, and it's 39 or 37, but I'm pretty sure it's 39. As a 39, yeah, he's 39, and Tyron Woodley's 35, I believe. So as a 39-year-old contender, you know, going against the welterweight champion, losing, fucking shooting 23 takedowns and being stuffed all 23 times, that's could be demoralizing. You know, you could take that you take that L and ride it as your sunset, like, fuck it, I fought for the title. Or come out here, this is another thing I thought about Maia. Not only do these contenders have to watch out, Jorge Masvidal, Donald Cerrone, Robbie Lawler, Stephen Wonderboy Thompson, all of those would be fine Maia fights. Not only do they have to, well, now we've got a potential contender for Nick Diaz. A welterweight contender for Nick Diaz. You know, Nick Diaz has been waiting on the perfect fight. He got flagged by USADA. He might be out for 6 months. But when he comes back in 6 months, if it's only 6 months, he could fight Dane Maia. That might be a fight that interests Nick Diaz that could further his legacy, another legend to put on his belt. Because no matter what you say about Damian Maia, as far as jiu-jitsu is concerned, he's legendary in MMA. And if you're not a fan of his fighting style, I'll just say this, and Tyron Woodley said this before the UFC 214, jiu-jitsu built the UFC. If you go back to UFC 1, 2, 3, Hoist Gracie was the show. The jiu-jitsu, it swept the nation. Everyone had to learn jiu-jitsu. Everyone had to, holy shit, how is this guy winning all of these fights? They had to learn jiu-jitsu. So now, just because everybody's learning jiu-jitsu now, you have to respect this, these specialists, because that's where MMA came from. So even if you can't be a specialist and be a dominant champion and just in jiu-jitsu these days, like Damian Maia, you know, and if he would have beat Tyron Woodley, that would have been arguable. But even though we're moving past that point, you still got to always put respect on fucking jiu-jitsu's name for the simple fact that built the UFC. UFC, you know, that's where jiu-jitsu did huge things for the UFC. I mean, wrestling is probably the most standard fighting base for the highest level fighters at this point in MMA, but at the same time, jiu-jitsu did build the UFC. That's just a fact, and it helped, definitely helped build the UFC. So a lot of people would argue it did build the UFC, so I'm not completely out of bounds saying that, so you can argue in the comments, oh, how long have you been watching fights, bro? Fedor's the GOAT. Man, shut the flying flippity flapjack fuck up. I can argue, okay, respect on, I didn't watch Fedor in his prime, and I know a lot of people have respect on Fedor's name. That's fine. I respect Fedor. He can be on the Mount Rushmore. You see, that I'm putting respect on his name because I didn't watch him in his prime, and I would still put him on Mount Rushmore just from the level of respect he has from fans. But you better get the fuck off of my head whenever I'm saying Jon Jones is the GOAT, and you're like, oh, no, Fedor would beat Jon Jones in his prime. Motherfucker, I'm talking about pound for pound. I'm talking about if Fedor went 205, or if these motherfuckers met in the middle at 220, Jon Jones is whooping that ass, dog, in prime to prime. And I'm saying that, and I can continue on that. I'm going to do that just for you fucking clown, you with your clown shoes on in the comments, came at me with that Fedor shit. And I said, I can go and find you reputable people in the MMA who have said Fedor's record is padded. That's not just Dana White who said that. And people always say, well, it's because Dana White wanted him at a cheap contract. Well, one of the facts that Dana White also said was Fedor fought a professional wrestler that had never fought MMA in his life. A quick Google, 2 second Google, you'll find his name is like Nugi Gakata, a Japanese dude that Fedor fought in 2003, who was a professional wrestler, like WWE shit. So if that's not padded to you, brother, we can argue that all day. I don't know what you said. What about Nogueira and Krokop? Okay, you can name 5 fighters out of, what, 40? Come on, man. Like, now go down Jon Jones' record. You can name about 15 of them motherfuckers and call them all arguable legends of their respective division of their respective time. Jon Jones is fucked up legends, all legends upon being undefeated, upon... So don't come at me with that. I'm a fucking clown for saying Jon Jones is the GOAT. You're an old entitled commenting bastard is what you sound like, dog. Oh, back in my day, Fedor would have beat everybody's ass. Shut the fuck up on that old rocking chair, dude. What the fuck you mean? Don't fucking watch the... Don't... If you got that much of a problem, if I'm a fucking clown, why are you listening, dude? Don't listen to the next video. Just move on in peace and go watch some other boring shit. What the fuck you time at, dude? With that being said, I thought I needed to tell Damian Maia. I done already went into who's next for fucking Tyron Woodley. So this comment section is going to be live. This is going to be the last video I do of the day. There's plenty on this video to dissect. There's plenty of shit I already put out today. It's about time to watch Game of Thrones with the fam bam, you know, my girl, my brother, his girl, my nephew might watch the shit. You know what it is, man. I'm gonna be on Snapchat, and I'm just gonna be doing other shit to get, you know, for the channel. I might not be putting up more videos, but I'm still always gonna be doing something for the channel, whether it's organized something on this computer, doing something for the motherfucking... Someone said, get a job, you clown. Bitch, you ain't been listening long enough. I got a fucking job. And by the way, I got work tomorrow, you fucking turd. So it is what it is. Hit thumbs up. Hit subscribe. Let the internet the fuck you tell me in the comments. And don't forget, if you share that video, that's what's up. I'm out. The other day, the doctor asked me, do you play sports? And I said, does sex count? He said, yes. I said, well, then no.